I was interested in computers, computer science departments didn't really exist, so when I went to grad school at Harvard, I was in the mathematics department. I wrote a thesis on the brand new field called computational complexity, which had to do with looking at the amount of resources, time, and memory to solve problems. So that was a new idea. So I came here, University of Toronto, which was a budding, brand new computer science department, recruiting some top people. And so that's where I've been ever since. I had this neat idea, introducing the concepts we now call NP completeness. That idea, that paper, it turned out to be the thing that has made me famous. Now, of course, there are thousands of known NP complete problems, and they're important enough that many different fields of computer science have been influenced by the concept. One of the classical NP complete problems is the so-called traveling salesman problem. Problem is, you're given N cities, N is a large number, 100 or something like that, and their locations on the map. What order should he visit the cities in order to minimize the total distance he travels? Now, if N is 100, 100 factorial is such a large number that no conceivable computer could ever consider all 100 factorial orders before the sun turned into a red star. So the mathematical question here that's open is whether every NP problem, the search problem, can be done and actually has a polynomial time solution. That's the P versus NP question. It's wide open. In fact, it is now one of the seven problems posted by the Clay Mathematics Institute. Millennium Prize problems, and they're offering $1 million to each problem to anyone who can solve any one of the problems. So it seems to be one of the seven important open problems in mathematics now.